Welcome to Contact. We're starting a new series today titled Possess Your Promise. And today's message is Learning Covenants. Now, this series is all about how we as Christians can possess all of the promises that God has made to us. So how do covenants help us possess promises?
God deals with man on a basis of covenants. We'll talk about that. And so it's like learning his language. So you're not going to understand the promises if you don't understand his language of how he's dealing with man.
Right, and covenant is not necessarily an everyday common usage word.
It isn't.
So, you know, it's going to be really important for you. This is really important to your Christian life. It's important for you to be able to receive from God. So hopefully you're going to stick with us through this broadcast so you can learn why God made covenants with man. We'll be right back.
The Bible is our greatest resource. It holds the key to our victory, our peace, our prosperity, and our salvation. But not everything within the Word of God is easily understood and oftentimes can be misinterpreted. Maybe you desire ministerial training or are looking for a deeper knowledge and stronger foundation of the Bible. Faith Landmark's Bible Institute offers you that strong foundation. With over 30 classes, up to 3 years of courses, and a dedicated group of teachers, FLBI sets you on the right track to fulfilling the Lord's will for your life. You can take classes on site, online, or on the go via our correspondence courses. On-site registrations for the new winter trimester begin November 11th. Classes begin December 9th. Enrollment for online classes and correspondence courses are available year-round. For more information and to sign up, simply visit www.flbi.org or call our office at 804-262-7104. We look forward to helping you fulfill your destiny here at Faith Landmark's Bible Institute.
Okay, so Luke chapter 22, verse 19, Jesus said, "And he took bread, and he gave thanks, and he broke it, and gave it to them, saying, 'This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me.' Likewise also the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you.'" Now, that's a big statement. We're going to take some time breaking that statement down. But notice the thing that he said about the bread. I'm just going to simulate this. He broke the bread. He said, "This is my body, which is broken for you." And that's a full-size loaf of bread right there. Okay, so he broke the bread. And then he distributed it to his disciples at the table. Hallelujah. Now, so we have a simulation of the cup here. It might not have looked exactly like that. The bread was probably flat. You know, cultural adaptation. Hallelujah. But Jesus was inviting his disciples to a covenant meal, or actually inviting them into a covenant that would be observed by participating in this covenant meal. Okay? Now, there's a lot of layers to this, but I'm going to show you today in this message how people can miss the message by hearing the wrong message and not seeing it and hearing it for what it is. So when Jesus made this statement to his disciples, it was based upon something that he had already been talking to them about. Okay? And it also, he'd been talking to them about it. You had to understand then, now this was 2,000 years ago, but you had to understand then the nature of a covenant meal to get the picture. So he took some time to explain that to his disciples. How many of you are a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ? Okay. Now the word disciple means disciplined one. So if you're a disciple of Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ, then that means you're a disciplined one of him, which means that you will be taught by him. Now we have a lot of things to learn. How many of you are willing to admit that you have a lot of things to learn? Okay. How many of you want your prayer life and your relationship with God to improve, to go up? Amen. Get a hold of the things of God. Actually be able to get your prayers answered with confidence in knowing that it's done and walk away expecting something to happen. See, that's actually what faith is. Okay, so Jesus' disciples, when he sat down that night with them, they had been going through the motions of this covenant meal as a part of their Passover observance for hundreds of years. But nobody had ever sat on the other side of the table and offered covenant. It's like an invitation, a covenant invite. So Jesus was actually inviting his disciples into a level of relationship, and they understood exactly what he was talking about. He had explained it to them. Hallelujah. God is good. Okay, now, so like I said, there's a lot of layers to this. That's a certain level of symbology, if you will. Okay. Praise God. Here's some of the, like today's language, here's some of the takeaways. Okay. The new covenant is a blood covenant. What in the world does that mean? Let's keep going. A blood covenant is a covenant which is secured by people's lives. Okay. Now, so first of all, a covenant is an agreement between two parties. It can be between nations. It can be between individuals. It can be between groups of people. Okay, but people come together to actually form a covenant. It's going to have terms, precepts, and then the parties that are going to enter into the covenant are going to they're going to have to sign something or participate in some way. In a blood covenant, it's participate with your life. Now, as it turns out, the book of Leviticus tells us that life is in the blood. Okay, so what the life of the flesh is in the blood. What in the world does that mean? If you take your blood out of your body, it's dead. So literally, life accesses the entirety of your body through the blood. Okay, now, so because life, which also means spirit, is in the blood, when you bind an agreement with blood, you're saying, I'm binding this with my life. Now, you participate in an economic system in the world today on the basis of your integrity, your name. Every time you buy something, do something, participate in any way, it's all based on your name. Often we deal with people on a basis in commerce on a basis of what's your name like at the bank, which is the reason why credit is such a big deal. You know, and the book of Proverbs tells us if your name is bad, then it's a bad thing for you. So a lot of what happens in the culture that we live in is all about our name. Well, with God, it's identical. It's all about his name. But he has to set the record straight about his name, okay, because the enemy has maligned God to mankind. That's what the devil does. Praise the Lord. And so when you accept God's promises, you're accepting his credibility, which is what Abraham did when God first started talking to him. So Abraham received Abraham heard a promise from God. This is recorded in Genesis chapter 12. Abraham believed the promise, which means his faith was involved, and it was accounted to him for righteousness. But by the time you get to Genesis chapter 15, God had already made good on a big part of the promise. But Abraham said, you know what? I still don't have an heir. I don't have a child to pass this covenant to. It wasn't just his possessions. It was a covenant that he had to pass down. And he didn't have an heir. Now, he had people in his house that, you know, other relatives and so forth that he could pass things to. But that wasn't the promise. So Abraham called God on the covenant and said, how do I know that you're going to do this? Now, he was already really blessed financially. That part of the covenant had already been made good and was working. But the seed part was yet to come. So God said, all right, I'll make a covenant with you. This is covenant language. I'm paraphrasing it for you a bit. Genesis chapter 15. God said, well, get me a ram, get me an ox. And he laid out the precepts of that day for a blood covenant. And then God entered into a blood covenant with a man. Hallelujah. This is big. You know, we're not going to be able to cover all this in one message. Okay. So God made a blood covenant because Abraham asked for security. How do I know? A guarantee. Are you willing to sign to that? And so God said, okay, I'll go you one better. We'll make it a blood covenant, which means this thing is secured in my blood. It will eventually be secured in the blood of man. And when a blood covenant is two parties shedding their blood into it's called a cup of mingling, and then drinking it. Now, in our culture, that sounds gross, but, you know, thousands of years ago, that was the way, instead of signing your name, if you were entering into an agreement that had to be secured, you were going to do it with your blood. Hallelujah. Now, when I was a kid, you know, we used to play with this in the neighborhood. We called it Blood Brothers. You know, so we would cut our hand and shake hands. And, you know, what were we doing? We were mingling blood. That's exactly right. So we were mingling lives, which, I mean, we were just stupid, of course. I had no idea, you know, what that meant, but it was just like, we won't come into your neighborhood if you won't come into our neighborhood. I mean, that's what that was. Are you there? But see, this covenant procedure is something that you're already familiar with. You're operating in it on a daily basis. When you leave here today, you're probably going to go and use your name to do something, probably eat out. And so there has to be security to your name. Otherwise, your name is no good. You can't use your name to do anything. But if you have a good name, you can actually use your name in commerce, without even having to actually have the stuff. It's your name that stands for you. Are you there? Okay, so everybody knows what that is. That's what a covenant is. When you buy a house in a neighborhood, you might not know this, but real estate agents know this. There's restrictive covenants and covenants for neighborhoods that are all written into the laws which control the property. Amen. So restrictive covenants or just covenants, the covenants of the property. You probably live in a neighborhood that has covenant agreements that are registered in the county, the city, for that particular district. And that's what actually those agreements is what holds the neighborhood together. It's at the base of the law. How many of you are with this? So what God is saying is, I want to enter into a covenant with you. So he proposed the whole thing to Abraham. Okay, you want a guarantee? Let's make it a blood covenant. Hallelujah. Now, how many of you are getting something out of this? So the blood covenant that God proposed, the original part, the promise part. See, he made a promise, but then Abraham asked for more, and God said, okay, I'll seal it with my oath. The word oath became a part of the terminology. Oath in Hebrew is blood covenant. Translates into the new covenant the same way. Are you there? So God swore an oath, which meant that he would shed his own blood. Now, the problem is, with God entering into a blood covenant, he didn't have a body. Abraham had blood, but he didn't ask for Abraham to shed his blood. So God entered into a unilateral blood covenant with Abraham based upon his own integrity, his name, that God would make his name good, which he did. So when Jesus came, Jesus is God's body. Oh, come on now. We're going to read that in the book of Hebrews. Are you with us? So God, when he made the promise, what was outstanding in the covenant was God didn't have any blood. Told you there was a lot of layers. So Abraham accepted God's word, and the covenant moved forward well enough for Jesus to be born. Jesus is God's lamb. He's also God's body. So when Jesus sat down at the table, I mean, this is deep. Are you out there? When Jesus sat down at the table that night with his disciples, he assumed God's side of the covenant as being the God now had a body. See, this is what you believed in when you accepted Jesus. Are you out there? You might not have known that. I had no idea this is what I believed when I accepted Jesus. All I did was ask for help. Help! Probably a lot like you. Hallelujah. But what you were actually doing is you were adding your faith to this covenant working. It's still working. And as you can see, where it started way back there with Abraham, there's been a progression. Things have been added. Things have been deleted. God took the law of Moses out of the covenant process. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Come on, can you say? Because Jesus fulfilled the law. Okay, but so Jesus sat down with them that night, himself in God's place. He's the one now who had a body. God had a body. And so that's the reason why the next day at Calvary, when they shed his blood, when he said, "It is finished," what was he talking about? God's promise was made complete. which fulfilled all the righteous claims of the law, accomplished all those things, redeemed mankind, paid for the sins of the entire world, because God now had a body that he was willing to give in sacrifice, fulfilling the covenant. Amen. Can you say...
Welcome back. Really glad that you've been with us today on Contact. And so this new language, which is a language of covenants, is spoken from God's perspective in that language. And so that's the reason why it's so vital for Christians to understand what he's talking about. Mm-hmm. And so the new covenant is a blood covenant. And so that's a certain type of a covenant with certain types of language, and you wouldn't have any idea what he was talking about if you didn't understand the nature of a blood covenant.
Right. So, you know, in today's world, people move into neighborhoods where they have an association, and usually there's covenants that govern what you can do, what you can build, you know,
kind of activities you can
have in
the neighborhood.
In that neighborhood. So people understand to a certain point that a covenant is really like a legal document.
Right.
So with that idea in mind, we need to understand that the Bible is a legal document.
Right.
That both the Old Testament and the New Testament is a covenant that God made that is all-inclusive.
Yeah.
You know, to the benefits of being connected with God through the covenant, right?
Right. And so here at Faith Landmarks, we're involved in spreading the gospel around the world. So if we do that in our own language, then it's not going to have an eternal effect on people.
Mm-hmm.
But if we speak his language,
right,
and he opens their ears to be able to hear it. See, a lot of times we think they're not getting it, you know. But when Jesus was talking to the multitudes, mm-hmm, that's exactly the way he talked to them.
Right.
And so that's what we do here at Contact. So we're busy spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ around the world. Now, in a few minutes, we're going to show you more about how we go about doing that. We'd like to ask you to participate and partner with us as we share the gospel by sowing seed into this ministry. Contact and Faith Landmarks are good ground. You can find everything that you need to know about this ministry right there on our website, contact.tv. Just follow the links. You can also sow a seed on your cell phone. There's a tab there. You can text this. We're putting at the bottom of your screen. You can text that. Use that as the information to get on board with your phone, and you can just give directly into missions right there from your phone. So helping to get the gospel out to the world through your giving is a vital part of your Christian experience.
So we're always really being engaged in fulfilling the Great Commission, which gives us a mandate to reach the entire world with the gospel. So we invite you to join us at Faith Landmarks Ministries for any of our weekly services or special events. And you can learn how to get involved. And if you don't live close enough to Richmond to join us regularly in person, you can still participate by joining us online at contact.tv or faithlandmarks.org. Now here's some exciting things we've been doing and a look at what's coming.
FLBI sets you on the right track to fulfilling the Lord's will for your life. On-site registrations for the new spring trimester begin February 10th. We look forward to helping you fulfill your destiny at Faith Landmarks Bible Institute. Open to children from kindergarten through fifth grade, Victory Christian Academy endeavors to train its students in both the physical and spiritual applications necessary for leading a successful life. With distinctive values and a dedicated staff committed to the growth and development of each student, VCA sets itself apart from the academic normality and encourages the advancement of both social and intellectual skills. We encourage you to check us out online at myvcanights.com.
Construction and renovations at Jesus Army Ministries are rapidly progressing. Not only is their main church building restored and enhanced, but also Pastor Simpson's house, which had previously been destroyed by severe weather, is almost completely rebuilt. Pastor Simpson is now more easily able to host pastor meetings and conferences, further helping to advance the gospel in India. Thank you, FLM, for your continued support in our missions effort. The revivals that will occur this February will be because of your faithful giving and prayers.
Contact with Randy and Cherie has been reaching our local community, our nation, and world abroad with the gospel. Since the beginning, it has been the heart of Pastors Randy and Cherie to see souls saved and lives changed through this broadcast. Because of your faithful support, Contact continues to grow and expand. We are reaching more people now than ever before. You can watch our broadcast on Fox Richmond, MyTV Richmond, MyTV Z Norfolk, ABC 7 Washington, and Fox 45 Baltimore. For air dates and showtimes, visit our website at contact.tv. Here, you can also view and stream our shows and partner with us from anywhere in the world. Would you like to become a partner with Contact? For your gift of any amount, you can become a partner today. Get monthly articles by Pastor, receive free gifts, and get the latest info on what's around the corner. Together, we are fulfilling the Great Commission. Thank you for your faithful support and commitment to spreading the gospel here on Contact with Randy and Cherie.
We'd like to thank you for joining us today on Contact. We believe that the Word has been sown into your heart, and you will be able to continue to receive from God and possess His promises in your life because of the Word that you've received. Now, before we go, we also want to remind you of any of our weekly services that we have here at Faith Landmarks Ministries. You're always welcome to come. May God richly bless and keep you, and we look forward to seeing you next time on Contact.